Congratulations to the bride and groom.
Congratulations, Nick.
A beautiful and day.
You look beautiful.
A beautiful couple.
Yes.
What's your message?
I love them both to death.
Yeah.
And I don't know where to sign the card.
Oh, okay. That's all right. And we've got to mention your shoes, apparently.
No, come on, with now.
Congratulations, Jen and Nick, you're a special couple. All the best for your future.
Have a good day. Hope it goes well.
Lovely, thank you.
Just say something.
Hope it all goes well today.
All the very best for the future, and I hope they have a lovely, peaceful marriage.
Brilliant. Great, thank you.
Hello, I'm Sue from City Mission and I've known Nick and Jen for years and years. Nick and Jen have always been a close pair and they've been wonderful to know. I'm really honoured to be invited to their lovely wedding today and it's a beautiful day too.
Good luck, Nick and Jen. Hope you have a good day.
Hey, would you like to say a little something for the video?
Not really.
No? Well, thanks for coming.
Okay, I'm
going
to have to swap you around,
Alan,
and you
just
be on the other side.
I said that! Right, so you're all ready to begin. What we'll do is we're just going to walk, get you off that first step, then we'll pause again.
Yeah, please.
And then,
please.
Then we've got the music, we'll get going.
Ready?
You'll be fine.
Welcome to Gloucester Cathedral as we gather today to celebrate with Jen and Nick the occasion of their marriage. Jen and Nick, it's wonderful to have you here in the cathedral on your wedding day and wonderful to welcome friends and family. I hope you are all in good voice, because there are various parts of this service where we're relying on you to join in, both with the singing of the hymns and then a few other bits and pieces which I'll explain as we go along. There are also a few other little changes to the order of service. The sharp-eyed among you will realise I am not Canon Nicky, I am Canon Andrew, and it's been my pleasure to work with Nick and Jen on preparing for this wedding, and we are so thrilled that you are getting married in your cathedral. At the start of our service, a sentence from the Bible which sets the scene for this Christian wedding. God is love, and those who live in love live in God, and God lives in them. We're going to sing together all things bright and beautiful. We have come together in the presence of God to witness the marriage of Jen and Nick, to ask God's blessing on them, and to share in their joy. Our Lord Jesus Christ was himself a guest at a wedding in Cana of Galilee, and through his Spirit he is with us now. The Bible teaches us that marriage is a gift of God in creation and a means of his grace, a holy mystery in which man and woman become one flesh. It is God's purpose that, as husband and wife, give themselves to each other in love, they shall be united in that love as Christ is united with his church. Marriage is given that husband and wife may comfort and help each other, living faithfully together in need and in plenty, in sorrow and in joy. It is given that with delight and tenderness, they may know each other in love, and through the joy of their bodily union, may strengthen the union of their hearts and lives. It is given as the foundation of family life, in which children may be born and nurtured in accordance with God's will, to his praise and glory. In marriage, husband and wife belong to one another, and they begin a new life together in the community. It is a way of life that all should honour, and it must not be undertaken carelessly, lightly or selfishly, but reverently, responsibly, and after serious thought. This is the way of life created and hallowed by God that Nick and Jen are now to begin. They will each give their consent to the other. They will join hands and exchange solemn vows. And in token of this, they will each give and receive a ring. Therefore, on this, their wedding day, we pray with them that, strengthened and guided by God, they may fulfill his purpose for the whole of their earthly life together. First, I am required to ask anyone present who knows a reason why these persons may not lawfully marry to declare it now. Silence is good. Thank you. Jen and Nick, the vows you are about to take are to be made in the presence of God, who is judge of all and knows all the secrets of our hearts. Therefore, if either of you knows a reason why you may not lawfully marry, you must declare it. I'm now going to ask Jen and Nick in turn whether they are willing from their heart to take each other as husband or wife. And your answer to the question is, I will. Nick, will you take Jen to be your wife? Will you love her, comfort her, honour and protect her, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live? I heard it, and Jen heard it, and that's what matters. Jen, will you take Nick to be your husband? Will you love him, comfort him, honour and protect him, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live? Now there's a bit for all of you to respond to now. I'm going to ask you a similar question, and at the end I want you all to respond with huge enthusiasm. We will. Will you, the families of friends of Nick and Jen, support and uphold them in their marriage, now and in the years to come?
We will!
Great. We pause for a moment of prayer. Let us pray. God, our Father, from the beginning you have blessed creation with abundant life. Pour out your blessing upon Jen and Nick, that they may be joined in mutual love and companionship, in holiness and commitment to each other, through our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. If I have all faith so as to remove mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away all my possessions, and if I hand over my body so that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love is not envious or boastful or arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice in wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. But as for prophecies, they will come to an end. As for tongues, they will cease. As for knowledge, it will come to an end. For we know only in part, and we prophesy only in part. But when the complete comes, the partial will come to an end. When I was a child, I spoke like a child. I thought like a child. I reasoned like a child. When I became an adult, I put an end to childish ways. For now we see in a mirror dimly, but then we shall see face to face. Now I know only in part, then I will know fully, even as I have been fully known. And now faith, hope, and love abide, these three, and the greatest of these is love. Here ends our reading. Jen and Nick, we've made it. Those three can stay sitting, don't they? That's all right. The day has arrived. You're supported by friends and family who love you and wish you well. And your wedding is happening in this amazing space of Gloucester Cathedral, and you saw Jen as we walked up the aisle with Alan and Heidi, people stopping and gawping and thinking, goodness me, who is this? Who is this extraordinary person who's got to marry in Gloucester Cathedral? So it's a wonderful day, and Nick and Jen, you are dressed just a little bit more upbeat and smartly than you might usually be on a Wednesday, I suspect.
I think you all are.
So here we are, dressed up, enjoying the day. The sun is shining wonderfully. It's an extravagant, joyful, hopeful day. But the most extraordinary and extravagant part of this day will be happening in just a minute or so's time, when Jen and Nick, you exchange your marriage vows. Because you're going to do one of the most extravagant things that any human being can do for another. That promise to love each other, in good times and in bad, in times of sickness and in times of health, in times of joy and times of sorrow. You're promising that to each other, and it's amazing, and it's extravagant. And that also means there will be times in your married life together when keeping to those promises might also be a bit costly. And when those things we just heard about in our reading, about patience, about trust, about faithfulness, will be very important to you. Nick, I think you said to me in Breakfast Club on Thursday, happy wife, happy life. I'm sure that's true. It's probably true, happy husband, happy life as well, Jeff. It doesn't quite have the same ring to it. But that is about looking out for each other, wanting the best for each other, even when you're really annoying to each other. Quickness happen every so often, but it's your love that will hold you together. And you've chosen wonderfully to make those promises here, in this ancient church. There's been a church here for over 1,000 years, a place that celebrates God's love for us, shown in Jesus Christ, God amongst us, sharing our life, feeling compassionate, loving for all. I'm going to pray at the end of your wedding that God's love for you will sustain you in your love for each other. So it's great to be part of this day, and we now come to the marriage. So Jen and Nick, if you come and stand over here to exchange your vows.
That's a good opportunity if you want, isn't it? Yeah. I'll still start.
Jen and Nick, I now invite you to join hands and to make your vows in the presence of God and his people. And Nick, you repeat after me. I, Nick, take you, Jen, to be my wife, to have and to hold, from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death us do part, according to God's holy law. In the presence of God I make this vow. Take these hands, and again, same hands, if you're taking Nick to be your husband. And Jen, repeat after me. I, Jen, take you, Nick,
to be my husband,
to have and to hold, from this day forward, for better, for worse,
for richer, for poorer,
in sickness and in health,
to
love and to cherish,
till death us do part,
according to God's holy law. In the presence of God I make this vow. Thank you. Kevin has completed his big moment. Well done. A prayer of blessing over the rings. Heavenly Father, by your blessing, let these rings be to Jen and Nick a symbol of unending love and faithfulness, to remind them of the vow and covenant which they have made this day, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. So you take the ring again. You place it on the forefinger of her left hand. And hold it there as you repeat after me. Jen, I give you this ring as a sign of our marriage. With my body I honour you. All that I am I give to you. And all that I have I share with you. Within the love of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Please hand. Same commit. Very good. Hold the ring as you repeat after me. Nick, I give you this ring. As a sign of our marriage. With my body I honour you. All that I am I give to you. And all that I have I share with you. Within the love of God. Father, Son and Holy Spirit. In the presence of God and before this congregation, Nick and Jen have given their consent and made their marriage vows to each other. They have declared their marriage by the joining of hands and by the giving and receiving of rings. I therefore proclaim that they are husband and wife. And trust. Lord of life and love, hear our prayer. May the hospitality of their home bring refreshment and joy to all around them. May their love for each other overflow to neighbours in need and to embrace those in distress. Lord of life and love, hear our prayer. May they discern in your word and in the Bible order and purpose for their lives. And may the power of your Holy Spirit lead them in truth and defend them in times of trouble. Lord of life and love, hear our prayer. May they nurture their family with devotion and come at last to the end of their lives with hearts content and in joyful anticipation of heaven. Lord of life and love, hear our prayer. We join together all our thoughts and prayers for Jen and Nick today as we say the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. God, the Holy Trinity,
make you strong in faith and love, defend you on every side, and guide you in truth and peace. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be amongst you and remain with you always. Amen. Nick and Jen, if you'd like to stand. And we're now going to come to the part of the day where we will sign the marriage documents. If those who've asked to be witnesses would like to come and join us up here, that would be super. Thank you very much. And as we sign the marriage documents, the organ will play some music for us. Thank you.
I had the privilege today of giving this lovely lady away. But I'm not the only one who has given here today. We've got some beautiful people at the back of the room who have participated and come together to make sure this lovely couple are having a joyous and momentous occasion, because we all believe in Jesus, we all believe in God, and we're all part of his big family, and I consider it a privilege and pleasure to be with you two today and all you good people. Without further ado, I shall call upon the bridegroom, Nicholas.
What?
Nick.
Nicholas.
To stand up and give a, say a few words on this joyous moment of occasion.
Well, I'm coming today and making a special day for Jenny and myself. Appreciate it. Thank you, everyone.
Beautiful. Thank you. And now I shall call upon...
Ben, he's cheating on the phone.
Ben.
Oi, put down the phone.
The deputy best man, who is the best man, who will say a few words on this august and momentous occasion when you can get it up.
Hey, Viagra.
I'm on your screen.
Hey, Viagra.
Pray silence for Mr. Ben.
Right, thank you.
You're reading off a text.
Shut up.
It's something new.
Today, ladies and gentlemen, we'll gather here to celebrate the joyful ceremony of the wedding of myself, Nick and Jen, of course. They are the beautiful wife and groom now, as we all witnessed in the Grand Cathedral earlier on. I still remember the first day that they said about a year ago they were going to get married. I could hardly believe it. But here we are today, and they've made such a fantastic time, fantastic day, and you look beautiful, and you are now married. Yep. So my duty is to ask you all to stand and raise your glass, please.
Stand up for something.
The happy bride and groom, Nick and Jen.
Nick and Jen.
Thank you.
Hip hip.
Hooray!